A patent ambiguity is one that appears on the face of a document. A latent ambiguity is one that only becomes apparent in context. How do courts resolve patent and latent ambiguities in wills? We explore that question in re estate of Cole. Ruth Cole executed a will and died shortly afterward. Cole's will included a monetary bequest to her friend, Veta Vining. The words of the will said that Vining would receive $200,000. In parentheses following those words, however, the will numerically identified the amount of the bequest as $25,000. The personal representative of Cole's estate petitioned the trial court and asked it to find that the bequest was for $25,000. Vining objected to that construction. The personal representative then moved for summary judgment. In support of the motion, the personal representative attached an affidavit from Robert Black, the lawyer who drafted Cole's will. Black explained that he used the copy and paste function on his computer when he drafted the bequest to Vining. Black replaced Vining's name and changed the numbers in the bequest to $25,000, as Cole had requested. He forgot, however, to change the text that referred to a $200,000 bequest. Vining didn't submit any evidence to contradict Black's testimony. The trial court determined that the bequest was patently ambiguous because the words specified one amount, but the numbers specified another. To resolve this ambiguity, the trial court considered Black's testimony. It found his testimony credible and construed the bequest to give Vining $25,000. Vining appealed to the Minnesota Court of Appeals.